Hello everyone and welcome to Monster Hunter Generations Ultimate. We're gonna try and get three monsters in today. First on the list is Ulvidon. I don't eat a lot when I do low rank because it's not as necessary, but I will eat a lot more when it comes to high rank. So we're in the volcano. The volcano actually doesn't have a lot of areas. Well, actually, I guess all but two of the areas technically will make us hot. You lose health over time if you don't take a cold drink and you go into hot areas. Bear with me for a moment. There's bugs that you can only get here that I need. That was a bust. I think the Volvidon will be in three because nope, he's in this one. So the Volvidon acts a lot like an armadillo, but also has a ridiculously long tongue. I honestly don't know. The Volvidon is another fanged beast. It can project a glob of spit that paralyzes. Bounces around like that, rolls over you, does its sidestep. It can hit you from long range with its tongue. Got it swiping like many fanged beasts with this body type. And it can emit gas from its body that, it'll give you the soil debuff, which you can't use items when you're soiled like that. So, now we can't use any healing items. Anything that you would drink or eat, you cannot use. There's his tongue, but if we pop a deodorant, we're fine. Volvidon has one breakable part. That is his shell. It might break twice, I can't remember. It doesn't really give you any combat advantages to break it, but a breakable part. So yeah, if you get hit by his saliva ball, he will most likely follow up with a aerial slam. That was unexpected. That does not have an AoE, I don't believe. It's just you either get hit by it or you don't. Amazed I didn't hit him in the head. He is staggering quite a bit. Oops, almost dodged into that attack. Back here, I'm trying to capitalize on my Valor stance. He's exhausted, even though I haven't hit him in the head once. That's really all there is to know about him. Hitting him from the back end is probably the best way to break his shell. Get back here, he's running away. Oh, we need a cold drink now. That's not the direction that I was holding when I said to dodge, but okay. This is most assuredly saying dodge to the side. What idiot would roll directly into the monster? Come on, game. Be reasonable. Like most monsters, when they get tired, he can't perform all of his actions anymore. But it's really an annoying thing that the Switch does sometimes, is that the, camera will just sometimes shift downwards. So, some of his tells, you can tell when he's about to use his tongue, but you don't really have a lot of time to counter it unless you can block or kill it off. And you can tell when he's about to gas because he'll emit it from his shell in slight amounts before he does his full burst. Oh gosh, what are the small ones called? I can't remember what these small monsters are, but I'm remembering what their large variant is called, which is an Agnaktor, who we'll meet later, probably much later. Tongue, and he missed. Another zone shift. Ted's actually relatively difficult to hit. He doesn't go down on all fours very frequently, and my upswings don't quite reach him. Very risky of me. Oh, come on. You should have at least let me get the hand off. Hello? Man, his shell is holding up. I missed horribly. So we're using Spinning Meteor 2. I think we probably were in the last episode as well. But I can't remember off the top of my head. You do more spins with Spinning Meteor 2 before you do the final slam than you do with 1, and it costs more to build up the gauge. He's not doing so hot. Got bad news. I'm gonna beat the crap out of you because I still haven't broken your back. Do 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 do. Sit still. His tongue hits mostly forward, but it hits to the sides a teeny tiny bit too. Gas. There we go in. Wow, the double stagger. He is scared of us. Now, there's a material that I need quite desperately from this place, so I'm gonna gather it while he goes to go sleep. And we can't capitalize anymore on our valor state, because it is gone. It was gonna go anyway. Need better pickaxes. Okay, no Dragonite from that one. Iopray, can you just go away? I'm clearly very busy right now. Ooh, a Rust Shard. Not what I was after, but I will take it. Hopefully we get a rusted weapon out of this. Rusted weapons have... when you restore them, they have good dragon element. I could go for his head, but I'm gonna go for his back as I'm trying to break it. That he's exhausted, so we're gonna get some hits in anyway. Shell being this hard to break. Got him. Sylvedon Claw. Claw. Shell. Okay, I'll be right back with the next monster. Okay, we're back. We're here to hunt a Najarala, which is a snake-like monster. I say snake-like because it has legs. The box gave us some tinged meat, which if a monster eats this... if a monster eats this, they, become paralyzed. It's an instant paralyzed, effect. I don't know where to start. No, not here either. Adrala have very many interesting things about them. There he is. So their major shtick is sound. See, they've got these hollowed scales on their tail and back that emit. They can rattle. Ow. At high frequencies. They can also drop off their scales like that. While the scales are flying through the air, obviously they have a sonic effect. It's a brief one, but it is a sonic effect. Oh, it's been a while since I've hunted one of these. Okay, this is somewhere where we really don't want to be. When he starts to do that, he's going to plow into the ground like that and come back up. That does a lot of damage, and he'll try to trap you with his tail. You'll have a small opening here, obviously, as you say. You've already broken his tail. Target him. He won't always explode his scales. They resonate with the ones on his back and explode if they've been released from his body. As far as breakable parts go, he's got his tail, his back, and his face. He's also got a supersonic roar, or supersonic... It's not really a roar, it's more like an air blast. Ow. Another thing that he can do is sometimes when he's doing that circle, he'll go in for a bite. And that will cause paralysis if he gets the bite off on you. As you can see, his tail, where we're hitting right now, is pretty weak, or is pretty susceptible to slash damage. You can always tell if part of the monster's body is taking an exceptional amount of damage from your weapon if the blood splatter that it gives is very large. And I think I must have forgotten one of his breakable parts, because... So we are not getting to his back or his face. We can get to his face, because when he'll do stuff like that, we have a brief moment to get some hits in. His back's not going to be breaking unless we get some mounts in, which we need this stump to do. Yeah, you can break his back, like I forgot about that. His tail is also super hard, you'll bounce off of it more often than not. And I think you have to hit the front of him in order to get mounted in space. So basically you can't hit anywhere along his tail, you have to hit his head or back. Could you not just let me get the thing on? He's changing zones. We're gonna chase after him. Do 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 do. Oh, he's exhausted already. That's unexpected. Hits extra damage on his face, too. And when he's exhausted, we can actually go after his back. He'll fall over whenever he does that charge. I believe breaking his back legs breaks both of them, because otherwise how on earth would you get to the other one most of the time? Well, that one didn't yet. I believe him rattling his back scales like that does have a sonic effect, but it's super cool. This attack, I guess you could call it, is exceptionally easy to avoid. You don't usually have to worry about it. Just keep on the move and stay away from where the ground's rumbling. Okay, I'm gonna do something really stupid. No, I'm not. I'm gonna end up getting pushed out. I was gonna see if I could shrug it off if I aimed myself in the direction of where he was going into the ground, but I was going to sacrifice my body for the sake of science, but he said, nope, uh-uh. See? Super easy to avoid, and when you're coming out of the ground, you have opportunities to use items. Can you break his arms? I don't mean that you can break his arms. Good luck doing it. Oh, he just straight up missed me. On his legs specifically where he's weak. As you can see, the scales on his back are also quite hard. When those scales explode, they hurt a lot. You don't tend to want to be anywhere near them. We're going to take advantage of that. So how tinged meats work is... Ooh, Vespoid body. You put it down, and then when the monster gets hungry, they will potentially go and eat it, rather than going to where they'd normally eat food. It obviously only works on carnivores. Herbivores will not go for the meat. Attest to that. Nobody really does. That's not even me being mean to the Volfango. Literally no one likes them. Okay, I dodged that. There's another opening that I could have capitalized on, but didn't. So this part of his tail is not especially susceptible to slashing damage. And now he's weak. He's got a weird walk cycle when he's weak. Might not actually be able to get more than two monsters off, because this has been going for quite some time. We're getting into the bigger monsters is the problem. The higher tier, the more healthy and stronger ones. We'll start doing deviant semi soon. I need some more elemental weapons. So what he did there is he dug into the ground and went straight here. It's annoying, but it's something they do. I was hoping that was it. Didn't mean to get pissed. Ugh, his scales are so hard. He's doing this again. And there you go. I would have liked to break his face because it increases our chances of getting fanged, but oh well. Without any good area places to mount him, it's not likely to happen. And that's why we give the cat earplugs. Okay, this is just Sonic Blast. You do not want to be in front of that when he does it. Ow. That poor Kelby got annihilated. There's the Sonic Cannon again. Oh dear. For science! You can shrug that off. It's ridiculous that you can shrug that off, but you can shrug it off. That's what I think of your Sonic Cannon. Hurts quite a bit to shrug it off, though. Oh, he's exhausted. Slap this down. Awesome, we broke his face. And he's dead. Carve him, damn it. Okay, at risk of this going on for far too long, we're gonna call the episode back when we get to the Hunter's Hub, so I'll catch you then. I said Hunter's Hub earlier, but I meant the village. But anyway, that's gonna call it for this episode of Monster Hunter. We'll hopefully see you in the next one. Thanks everyone so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like to let me know and subscribe if you'd like to see more. I hope you all have a wonderful day and I'll see you in the next video.